Welcome back to our London Canal Walks series here at Wandsworth Bridge. We're going to carry on walking from here. You may notice a few changes since the last video. I don't know how long it's been since the last video went up, probably a few weeks. But since we were last here, it's been about 3 months. We were last here at the end of January. It is now Easter Monday in the middle of April, so it's looking a little more spring and a little less winter than last time. At the end of the last video, we just saw the entrance to Battersea Reach. So we're now going to go back down here, under the bridge, into Battersea Reach. Battersea Reach looks to be some other fancy looking housing. And towers. Plantation Wharf Pier, apparently. Be some forms of abandoned dock or jetty or something. The buildings behind us are called Molasses House, and this here is Molasses Row. So I assume this would have been a point at some point in the past where boats would have come up the river and delivered molasses. Also, metal detecting along the foreshore seems to be popular. There's one guy here. There's another couple of people just up here. And I think there's some more right up there. This potentially gives us some idea what that dock up there at Molasses House looked like. You've got here a flat plain built out from the bank out on top of the pillars in the foreshore there. And actually, flat plain might be a similar, might be a sensible sort of word. This is London Heliport. We're going to be able to see from here. Heliport, where you can get a helicopter to and from. Not sure where, but I did have a guess that it's probably people who fly in on their private jet get their private helicopter up to the heliport. But I don't know. Squeaky bouncy bridge. These are just weird bits of what was once presumably a slipway down into the river, now sort of abandoned, surrounded by businesses and such. Wide beam down here. Just weird bits of old infrastructure. Over there is Chelsea Harbour and Chelsea Harbour Marina. I wasn't sure where, but there does seem to be a gate right in the middle of the wall there. So presumably they have a maintained level marina over there, and they can only open that gate when the river's at high tide. You have to time your comings and goings to that marina quite rigorously. Thank you. and go exploring. Now this is how you get onto the foreshore. Yeah, squidgy. Okay, you should probably have wellies on for this. Slippery down here. This one actually has boats in it. Oh, and lock gates. Well, gates. This bridge feels like it was made in the time when they were showing off what they could do with metalworking. We've got on the cable or wire attachment points here, you've got little stars, and then they've gone to an effort to make all these sort of lacy porthole attachments all up the bridge. So this feels like it was, yeah, showing off what we can do with metalwork. This is Albert Bridge. I think this used to be a toll bridge. It makes a bit of a noise when things cross it because it's all been all the road surface has been replaced with plates. Protected, I think. It doesn't get used for moving an awful lot of products around anymore, but it does get used for moving rubbish a lot in London because no one really cares massively about the speed rubbish gets moved at, as long as it gets moved. Thank you. is our swans for today. Sounds like being at the seaside. You can imagine this being a grand Victorian promenade with all the Victorian ladies in their big dresses, the little parasols wandering up and down on a sunny day. Do a little bit of exercise and then go home again. The area of London that we're coming into now is all new to me. I mean, some of it, you can see, is still being built on the right there, so it's new to anyone. But this is the area around Battersea Power Station, which for years I used to get the train into London, and you'd see the whole area around Battersea Power Station was just abandoned, empty and derelict, and they've relatively recently been turning it into somewhere, into a place. So they've been building apartments and leisure facilities and sprucing up the waterfront, so it'll be interesting to have a look. So what was once abandoned and unused, I mean, I think the power station, actually I was going to say the power station is still unused, though they've built loads of stuff on top of it. So it's coming back to life, to usefulness.
Yeah.
presumably where they brought coal into the power station, unloaded coal for the power station. And here we go. It's like a massive diving board. I'm sure that's not what it is, but that's what it looks like. One of those cartoon Tom and Jerry massive diving boards. It looks like we've hit the end of the bit that's been developed so far. It's a wiggly tower block over here, I'll show you in a second. Wiggly tower block. Well, I'm all for design that's not take a box and divide it up. I think we want to be going in this direction because we want to be heading back towards the left, back towards the river. We're just trying to find our way back to towards the river, which I think is in that direction. left round here and head that way and see if that gets us a bit closer to the river. Found the water again. It's a rather funky boat with a spiral slide around the outside of it. Is that a real tree trunk, or is that an artistic tree trunk? I'm guessing that's an artistic tree trunk. It looks like it's got fabric stretched over the outside of it. That's because I think it has. Sun shading because of all the glass. This is something train related. It looks like a sort of train water tank. Not really sure.
Oh no, this is supposed to work on
to be over there somewhere, but the footpath there is closed, so I think we have to go around this building, which is MI5, I think. So we've got two signs here. One says Thames Path, temporary diversion to the left, and the other one says Thames Path closed, please follow diversion and go straight on. So, okay, Thames Path would have gone down here through more building site. And I think that where that building site is, that used to be a slipway that the London Duck Tours went down, which is submersible buses. So they drive on the road and then they just drive into the river and become a boat. So I guess the path used to go down there back to the river, but it's Thames Tideway building site. I'm going to assume this sign here has got itself turned around and that the Thames path does not go in that direction, that it comes back down to the river here. I see lots of London landmarks. I see the London Eye and Houses of Parliament. Just looking at this building, thinking that looks like a fire station, and I think I might be right, given that directly opposite it we have the Lambeth River fire station. Cue jokes about rivers catching on fire and things like that, but presumably they have boats they can get up and down the river at speed and then pump river water up to land appliances, or just pump river water straight onto fires on the bank. There'd be a boat crashed through the front of this building here from the inside.
When I saw a picture of it,
Crumb Bucket's Mechanical Dragon. Musical Engine of Distinction. Thank you.
go off it.
No, just like.
These hearts and this wall carry on actually further than I can see down there, probably right the way down to the next bridge. You don't see many narrow boats on the Thames, but you can do the bit we're walking here from one end of the canal down the Thames back to Limehouse. You can do that in a narrow boat. I think it's usually advised to have a pilot, but you have to check your tide timings very carefully so that the tide doesn't outstrip the speed your boat can do and you end up going backwards, but it's possible. The newly restored Elizabeth Tower and Houses of Parliament, most commonly and incorrectly called Big Ben. Big Ben is the bell. We had this when I passed the bubble cutout on the narrowboat way back. It's undergone a massive refurbishment and not been chiming at all except for New Year's for years, and this is the first time we've come back past and seen it newly refurbished. It's looking very shiny and very. All the gold bits at the top looking nice and shiny.
Let's play with this one.
So this wall has previously been a different memorial. CJD, it's going back a while. Dark and smelly in here.
I cannot see a thing.
Now we hit the proper touristy bits of London.
Thank you.
County Hall, so in here you've got a McDonald's and an arcade and Sea Life Centre, steak bar. Used to be London Dungeons here, they moved that. London Eye Experience is in there. I don't know if there's actually any of the original sort of County Hall offices in there. I think it's all other stuff there.
If we don't come back through those big trams in there, those big trams in there.
Oh, I was wrong, there is still a London Dungeon experience here. This is the sort of place where you get the living statues. Oh, I can't see any. Oh, here's one. This is the sort of place where you get these living statues. You either get the levitating yod or everyone knows how it's done. This one's actually one I haven't seen before, which is quite impressive, quite something. Book fair's on.
Thank you.
This used to be South Bank TV Studios, owned by ITV, but we've been here a number of times. I've been here a number of times for various things. See various things filmed, including QI and a couple of pilots that never got commissioned, but it's closed now, so I'm not sure quite what it's going to be. Probably flats. Most things that get closed get turned into flats. Either that or offices. When we come through sort of popular London, we start getting back to these weird little old pier things that are no longer in use, but presumably would have been for something. You're not allowed on them. I can never remember if this is the same OXO as the stock cubes, but I assume either it was, but isn't, or it just isn't. So I'll put an explanatory thing on. Need to go find out. This is Blackfriars Bridge, which looks like it's another look what we can do with metalwork bridge. Lattice work, and there's a name for those floral bits that you stick on things, but I can't remember what it is. And then you've got modern things like this sort of squished looking building up here. Under Blackfriars Bridge. You've then got pillars where an old bridge used to be. Then next to that, you've got Blackfriars Station, which is a station that spans both sides of the River Thames, which is kind of cool. So, Blackfriars Bridge, old Blackfriars Bridge, Blackfriars Bridge Station. And some slightly damp stairs. Thank you. Anyone remembers old Tim's TV? It's a familiar sight. Well, I think this is where we are going to end our walk for today. Tate Modern at the Millennium Bridge. There will be one more main installment of today where we walk from here back to Lighthouse Basin where we started oh so long ago. And then we might do one extra walking up the Hartford Union Canal. Just do a little loop around there and that will complete our London Canal Loop series and we'll then see where we go from there. So thank you very much for joining us. We're gonna go have a lovely rest of our bank holiday afternoon. I hope you do too.